Atoms are the base for all matter, so it's pretty important to have a good understanding of them and the way they work. This video is part one of a three-part series which will cover all you need to know to have a good grasp of the atomic theory, starting with this video, the history of the atomic theory. The idea of the atom can be traced all the way back to ancient Greece in 430 BC, when Democritus proposed that if you divide something enough times, you will get to a point where you can't divide it anymore, and you will be left with a tiny, indestructible, invisible particle. He named these particles atomos, meaning indivisible. Skip ahead a long time and you get to a man named John Dalton, who in 1811 refined and added on to Democritus' atomic theory. While he kept the idea of atoms being indestructible, he added on that all atoms of the same element are exactly identical in both mass and properties. He also added on that compounds are just the combinations of multiple different kinds of atoms, and that chemical reactions are just the rearrangement of those atoms. The electron, however, wasn't discovered until 1897 when a man named J.J. Thompson discovered them and proposed an atomic model resembling plum pudding, with a positively charged dough and negatively charged raisins sprinkled throughout. While this did explain some of the electrical properties of atoms, it didn't represent the positive charges as separate particles. In 1911, a student of Thompson's named Ernest Rutherford discovered a flaw in Thompson's plum pudding model. He discovered that atoms had a dense nucleus which held most of the mass of the atom. With this knowledge, he scrapped the plum pudding model and created a new model, resembling a solar system, with the electrons orbiting around the nucleus, much like planets around the sun. Come 1913, a man named Niels Bohr modified Rutherford's model by saying that electrons orbited in stable, stationary orbits around the nucleus, and that each orbit had its own energy level depending on the distance from the nucleus. His model also claimed that light was emitted from an atom when an electron moved from a higher orbit to a lower orbit, and that light was absorbed when an electron moved from a lower orbit to a higher one. Though close to the modern atomic model, there was still one major modification to the Bohr model to reach where we are today. This modification was made by Erwin Schrodinger in 1926 when he proposed the electron cloud model. This model claimed that we can never know exactly where an electron is at any given moment, but that their location is governed by probability. For instance, an electron could be infinitely far away from the nucleus, but it is much more likely to be much closer to the nucleus. This is more or less the model we use today. This was just a brief overview of the history of the atomic theory, and in no way includes everything there is to know about it. It's also a good thing to keep in mind that theories are always changing. Someone could come along and prove the electron cloud model wrong, and add yet another chapter into this interesting story. Who knows? That person could even be you. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, why not subscribe for more in the future, and if you want more right now, how about checking out some of my other videos from the past? Thank you so much for watching this video, and have a wonderful day.